Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about the concept of ideal transform, an equivalent circuit, no load and all load phasor diagram of single phase transform. So myself Mr. Santanu Naskar, Assistant Professor of Electrical Department, GKCMJIS Group. My mail ID is santanu.uit@gmail.com. And santanu.noskar_gkcm@jisgroup.org, and this is my Facebook page, Being Electrify with Santanu. So let us discuss about your syllabus. So I have already covered the general introduction of rotating machine and DC generator and DC motor, and in transformer I have covered principal operation, EMF equation, transformation ratio, KVA rating, type of transformer. And now today I will start the concept of ideal transformer, performance under no load condition with phasor diagram, performance under no load condition with phasor, on load condition with phasor diagram, and equivalent circuit. So these all are very important in electrical transformer, and also very important topic for electrical engineering. So before start the topic, I will share with you some idea that life is similar to a transformer. Sometimes we step down, sometimes we step up. So be positive always. Okay, so let us start. So what is an ideal transformer? So definition is the transformer which is free from all type of losses is known as an ideal transformer. Actually it is an imaginary transformer that has no core loss, no ohmic loss and no leakage flux. The ideal transformer has the following important characteristics. Number one, the resistance of their primary and secondary winding becomes zero. The core of the ideal transformer has infinite permeability. The infinite permeable means less magnetizing current required for magnetizing their core. And number three, the leakage flux of the transformer becomes zero. Like the whole of the flux induced in the core of the transformer links with the primary and secondary winding. And number four, the ideal transformer has 100% efficiency, which is not possible in practical. And the transformer is free from hysteresis and eddy current loss. This is also not possible. We can reduce the hysteresis and eddy current loss, but we can't remove it. So the above mentioned properties are not possible in the practical transformer. So in an ideal transformer there is no power loss, therefore the output power is equals to the input power. So E2 I2 cos phi equals to E1 I1 cos phi, or E2 I2 equals to E1 I1, or we can say E2 by E1 equals to I1 by I2, since E2 proportional to N2 and E1 proportional to N1, also E1 is similar to V1 and E2 is similar to V2. So therefore the transformer Mason ratio, we can say that V2 by V1 equals to E2 by E1 equals to N2 by N1 equals to I1 by I2 equals to K. So the primary and the secondary current are inversely proportional to their respective turns. Now comes to the behavior of ideal transformer. So consider an ideal transformer shown in this figure. Okay, the voltage source V1 is applied across the primary winding of the transformer. Their secondary winding is kept open. Okay, the N1 and N2 are the number of turns of the primary. Okay, the current Im is the magnetizing current flows through the primary winding of the transformer. The magnetizing current produces the flux phi m in the core of the transformer. As the permeability of the core is infinite, the flux of the core link with both the primary and secondary winding of the transformer. So the flux link with the primary winding induce the EMF E1 because of self induction. The direction of the induced EMF is inversely proportional to the applied voltage V1. The EMF E2 induced in the secondary winding of the transformer because of mutual induction, which I have discussed in my previous transformer video. In working principle of single phase transformer, I have already discussed. So now comes to the phasor diagram of single phase transformer. So the phasor diagram of the ideal transformer. So the phasor diagram of the ideal transformer is shown in this figure. As the coil of the primary transformer is purely inductive, the magnetizing current induced in the transformer lags 90 degree by the input voltage. So look here, this lags 90 degree by the input voltage V1. The E1 and E2 are the EMF induced in the primary and secondary winding of the transformer. The direction of the induced EMF inversely proportional to the applied voltage. So E1 and E2 situated here. And some point to be remember that the input energy of the transformer is equals to the output energy. The power loss in the ideal transformer is zero. So now go through the transformer on load condition, on no load condition. Let's start. So how transformer behave on no load condition, and what is the how the phasor diagram is derived? Okay, so when the transformer is operating at no load, the secondary winding is open circuited. Okay, so there is no load because of this, so secondary winding is open circuit, which means there is no load on the secondary side of the transformer, and therefore current in the secondary will be zero. Okay, while primary winding carries a small current I0, this one, although it is called I0, and this is called no load current, which is 2 to 10% of the rated current. Okay, so this current is responsible for supplying the iron losses, which is based on hysteresis and eddy current losses in the core, and very small amount of copper losses in the primary winding. The angle of lag depends upon the losses in the transformer. The power factor is very low and varies from 0.1 to 0.15. So the no-load current consists of two components. One is reactive or magnetizing component IM. It is in quadrature with the applied voltage. Okay, so this is the applied voltage. This is quadrature with the applied voltage V1, and it is produced flux in the core and does not consume any power. So it is produced flux. Look here, it produced flux. So this flux and IM is in same phase and does not consume any power. And second one is active or power component, this one. Okay, this is also known as working component. It is in phase with the applied voltage. Look here, this is phase with the applied voltage V1. It is supplies the iron losses and small amount of primary copper losses. Okay, so these are the following step to draw the phasor diagram. So let's start one by one. Number one is the function of the magnetizing component is to produce the magnetizing flux, and thus it will be in phase with the flux. Okay. Number two, induced EMF in the primary and the secondary winding lags the flux by 90 degree. look here, in DC may V1 E2 lags the flux by 90 degree, okay. Number 3, the primary copper loss is neglected and secondary current losses are 0, so I2 is 0, so here is no I2. Therefore, the current I0 or I0 lags behind the no voltage vector V1, look here, lags behind the no voltage vector V1 by an angle phi 0. Lags mean clockwise. Phi 0, which is called the no load power factor angle. This is called no load power factor angle. Okay. Now number 4. The applied voltage V1 is drawn equal and opposite to the induced EMF E1. Okay. Look here, this is equal and opposite. V1 is equal and opposite to E1 and E2. Because the difference between the two at no load is negligible. Okay. Number 5. Active components active component IW or it is called working current is drawn is in phase with the applied voltage. Look here, this is phase with the applied voltage. Number 6. The phasor sum of magnetizing current IM and the working current IW gives the no load current I0. So these two component gives the I not current. Okay. So this is the vector sum. So from the phasor diagram, the following conclusion made: working component IW equals to I0 cos phi 0, no load current equals to no load current I0 equals to root over IW square plus IM square, and magnetizing component IM equals to I naught sine phi naught, and power factor cos phi 0 equals to IW by I0, and no load power input P0 equals to V1 I0 cos phi 0. So this is all about transformer in no load condition. So next we will discuss about the equivalent circuit of a transformer. So what is an equivalent circuit of a transformer? The equivalent circuit diagram of any device can be quite helpful in the predetermination of the behavior of the device under the various condition of operation. It is simply the circuit representation of the equation describing the performance of the device. So the simplified equivalent circuit of a transformer is drawn by representing all the parameters of the transformer either on the secondary side or on the primary side. The equivalent circuit diagram of the transformer is shown here. Okay. Let the equivalent circuit of a transformer having the transformation ratio K equals to E2 by E1. The induced EMF E1 is equals to the primary applied voltage V1 less primary voltage drop. This voltage causes current I0, no load current, in the primary winding of the transformer. The value of no load current is very small and thus it is neglected. So hence I1 equals to I1 dash. The no load current is further divided into the two component called magnetizing current IM and working current IW. This is also called core loss current, and this is called core loss resistance, and this is magnetizing reactance. So these two component of no load currents due to the current drawn by non-inductive resistance R0 and pure reactance X0 having voltage E1 or V1 primary drop, the secondary current I2 is I1 dash by K equals to I1 minus I0 by K. So the terminal voltage V2 across the load is equals to the induced EMF E2 in the secondary winding, less voltage drop in the secondary winding walker. Now we will discuss about the equivalent circuit when all the quantities are referred to primary side. Okay, so let us discuss. In this case, to draw the equivalent circuit of the transformer, all the quantities are to be referred to the primary. Look here in this circuit as shown in this figure. The following are the values of resistance and reactance given here. Secondary resistance referred to the primary side is given as R2 dash equals to R2 by K2. The equivalent resistance referred to the primary side is given as R equivalent equals to R1 plus R2 dash, and the secondary reactance referred to the primary side is given as X2 dash equals to X2 by K2, and the equivalent reactance referred to the primary side is given as X equivalent equals to X1 plus X2 dash. Okay, so now we will discuss about the equivalent circuit when all the quantities are referred to the secondary side. So the equivalent circuit diagram of the transformer is shown in this circuit when all quantities are referred to the secondary side. Okay, so the following are the values of the resistance and reactance given here. Primary resistance referred to the secondary side is given as R1 dash equals to K square R1, and the equivalent resistance referred to the secondary side is given as R equivalent, this S means secondary, equals to R2 plus R1 dash, and primary reactance referred to the secondary side given as X1 dash equals to K square X1. And the equivalent reactance referred to the secondary side is given as X equivalent equals to X2 plus X1 dash. So no load current I naught is hardly 3 to 5% of full load rated current. The parallel branch consisting of resistance R naught and reactance X naught can be omitted without introducing any applicable error in the behavior of the transformer under loaded condition. Further simplification of the equivalent circuit of the transformer can be done by neglecting the parallel branch consisting R0 and X0, which is shown here. So this is the simplified circuit diagram of the transformer. So this is all about the equivalent circuit of the transformer. Now we will discuss about the transformer on load condition. So here I will discuss about how transformer behave on load condition and how to draw the phasor diagram on load condition. So when the transformer is on loaded condition, the secondary of the transformer is connected to the load. The load can be resistive, inductive, or capacitive. The current I2 flows through the secondary winding of the transformer. The magnitude of the secondary current depends on the terminal voltage V2 and the load impedance. The phase angle between the secondary current and voltage depends on the nature of the load. Okay. Now I will discuss some of operation of transformer on load condition. So the operation of the transformer on no load condition, just go through these pictures and equation and listen my words. So when the secondary of the transformer is kept open, it draws the no load current from the main supply. The no load current induces the magnetomotive force N0I0, and this force set up the flux phi in the core of the transformer. The circuit of the transformer at no load condition is shown in this figure. Now this is just load condition. So when the load is connected, this load condition is shown in this figure. So when the load is connected to the secondary of the transformer, I2 currents flow through the secondary winding. The secondary currents induce the magnetomotive force N2I2 on the secondary winding of the transformer. This force set up the flux phi2 in the transformer core. The flux phi2 opposes the flux phi according to Lenz's law. As the flux phi 2 opposes the flux phi, the resultant flux of the transformer decreases and this flux reduces the EMF E1. Thus, the strength of the V1 is more than E1, and an additional primary current I1 dash drawn from the main supply. The additional current is used for restoring the original value of the flux in the core of the transformer so that V1 equals to E1. Now the primary current I1 dash is in phase opposition with the secondary current I2. Thus, it is called primary counterbalancing current. The additional current I1 dash induces the magnetomotive force N1I1 dash, and this force set up the flux phi1 dash. The direction of the flux is the same as that of flux phi, and it cancels the flux phi2 which induced because of MMF N2I2. Okay. Now we can say N1I1 dash equals to N2I2, therefore I1 dash equals to N2 by N1 into I2, which is called KI2. This N2 by N1 is turns ratio. Now the phase difference between V1 and I1 gives the power factor angle phi1 of the primary side of the transformer. The power factor of the secondary side depends upon the type of load connected to the transformer. If the load is inductive as shown in this figure, okay, the power factor will be lagging, and if the load is capacitive, the power factor will be leading. So lagging means clockwise, leading means anti-clockwise. The total primary current I1 is the vector sum of the current I0 and I1 dash. So this I1 vector equals to I0 vector plus I1 dash vector. Now we will discuss about the most important topic of single phase transformer, phasor diagram of transformer on inductive load. So the phasor diagram of the actual transformer when it is loaded inductively shown in this figure. So there are some steps to draw the phasor diagram. If you remember those steps, then you will definitely draw the phasor diagram easily. So just listen my word and go through this picture. Take flux phi as a reference. Okay, then induce EMF E1 and E2 lags the flux by 90 degree. Okay, this E1 E2 lags the flux 90 degree. The component of the applied voltage to the primary equal and opposite to the induced EMF in the primary winding E1 represented by V1 dash. So this V1 dash is equal and opposite to E1 E2. Current I0 lags the voltage V1 dash by 90 degree. This I0 lags the voltage by 90 degree. Okay, this I0 lags the voltage approx 90 degree. The power factor of the load is lagging because this is inductive. Then therefore current I2 drawn lagging E2 by an angle phi2. So this current lag E2 by phi2. So this resistance and the leakage reactance of the winding result in a voltage drop, and hence secondary terminal voltage V2 is the phase difference of E2 and voltage drop. So we can say V2 equals to this V2 equals to E2 minus voltage drop. These are the voltage drop I2R2, I2X2. So I2R2 is in phase with I2 because this is resistive drop, and I2X2 is quadrature with I2 because this is inductive. So the total current flowing in the primary winding is the phasor sum of I1 dash and I0. So this I1 is the phasor sum of I1 dash and I0. Primary applied voltage V1 is the phasor sum of V1 dash and the voltage drop in the primary winding. So V1 is the phasor sum of V1 dash, I1R1 and I1X1. I1R1 is in phase with I1 and I1X1 is quadrature with I1. Now the phasor difference between V1 and I1 gives the power factor angle phi1. This I am talking about this phi 1. of the primary side of the transformer. Now the power factor of the secondary side depends upon the types of load connected to the transformer. Now if the load is inductive as shown in this figure, the phasor diagram, the power factor will be lagging, and if the load is capacitive, the power factor will be leading, where I1 R1 is the resistive drop and the primary winding I2 X2 is the reactive drop in the secondary winding. Similarly, after that I will discuss about the phasor diagram of transformer on capacitive load. So the transformer on the capacitive load, which is also called leading power factor load, is shown in this phasor diagram. And here we discuss about some step. Again, if you remember those step, you will definitely draw easily the phasor diagram on capacitive load. So first take a flux phi as a reference. Induce EMF E1 and E2 lags the flux by 90 degree. Same, the component of the applied voltage to the primary equal and opposite to induce EMF in the primary winding E1, which is represented by V1 dash, same as inductive load. Current I0 lags the voltage V1 dash by 90 degree. This, I am talking about this current. Now the power factor of the load is leading, so therefore current I2 drawn leading E2. So this I2 is leading now, okay. Now the resistance and the leakage reactance of the winding result in a voltage drop, and hence the terminal voltage V2 is the phasor difference of E2 and voltage drop. So we can say V2 equals to E2 minus voltage drop, which is I2 R2 and I2 X2, where I2 R2 is in phase with I2 and I2 X2 is in quadrature with I2. Now current I1 dash is drawn equal and opposite to the current I2, okay. This I1 dash I am talking about. Now the total current I1 flowing in the primary winding is the phasor sum of I1 dash and I0. So this I1 equals to the phasor sum of I1 dash and I0. Now primary applied voltage V1 is the phasor sum of the V1 dash and the voltage drop in the primary winding. So V1 is the phasor sum of V1 dash, I1 R1 and I1 X1. So V1 equals to V1 dash plus I1 R1 plus I1 X1, which I1 R1 is in phase with I1 and I1 X1 is in quadrature with I1. Okay. Therefore, the phasor difference V1 and I1 gives a power factor angle Phi1 of the primary side. I am talking about this Phi1. The power factor of the secondary side depends upon the type of load connected to the transformer. So this is all about the phasor diagram of various load, inductive and capacitive. So this is all your transformer, no load, on load, ideal transformer, phasor diagram in inductive load, phasor diagram in capacitive load. So these are some reference of your lecture and also your subject, electric machine by Ashfaq Hussain and Harun Ashfaq. Electric Machinery by Dr. P.S. Bhimra. This is very good book. According to me, this is very compact book. Principle of Electrical Machine by V.K. Mehta, Rohit Mehta. And these are some reference site, NPTEL's video lectures by IITs and Circuit Globe and Electrical for You. These are some good site of electrical engineering. So thank you, hope you all enjoy my lecture. So stay safe and stay blessed. Thank you.